another one. So this time I will show you how to work with permissions. So here I have in demo version already two groups, operators, administrators, and I have two roles, administrators and operators. Each role consists of individual permissions. And if we go to groups, each group can have more than one role assigned. So permission workflow is group role permissions. So also I have now created one user operator, and he belongs to operators group. Also now, for example, there is also a useful utility like permissions explorer. For example, if you go to permissions explorer to use this URL, operator has to have this permission. Permission and explorer. Now, as you see in another tab, I'm logged in incognito window as operator. And for this example, I have selected online visitor, but I still don't see this widget. So what I'm missing, I go to documentation, I find this online visitor. Okay, it requires users online and this permission if you want him to see all the visitors. So what can I do? I go to list of roles. I edit this role and I add new permissions. So chat module, and it was online users, and it was this, sees all online users. So he will see all the online visitors, not only from his department. Let's click save. Now if I refresh here, you see online visitor widget appears. Similar flow can be applied to any of the widget. Also, documentation clearly states what permissions are required for specific parts. So that's the way you work with permissions and so on. And each of these links can be configured same way, because as you see, operator has very limited permissions. In addition to that, you can always check what permissions he has a specific operator by going to his account and clicking permissions. I'm looking now as myself, now logged visitor, but same you can do by going to users and editing users and clicking show permissions. So you will see same information.